Hello and welcome to another What's Inside. Today we are looking at Brain Games, the game. This is from 2015 from Buffalo Games and Puzzles. That's who produced it, but it's owned by National Geographic, of course. So it's based on the TV show from the National Geographic Channel. It's aimed at ages 14 and up. You need 3 to 6 players to play this game. And it does look fairly complex. This is a pretty heavy box, so there's quite a bit in here. So inside we're going to see 192 challenge cards, 40 game tiles, 6 scorecards, 6 pawns, game board, game die, and instructions. So let's open this up and see what it looks like. Okay, so these are the scorecards. Well, we'll take all these out and see what we get. Ooh, there's a little lid thing here. Lift here. Oh, well, that's fancy. Oh, there's a spot here to bust these out, these 4 pieces, and you put the decks in there. That's handy. All right, we'll look at this stuff in a minute. Let's take a look at the bigger pieces here. Okay, here's our scorecards. This is just folded in half, so it's actually one sheet. And they're all identical. It says Brain Trust, scorecard. You know, nothing particularly exciting about that. And there's nothing on the back. It's just blank, unprotected cardboard. Okay. Looks like the game board is actually in little squares. And the card deck is gigantic. So, let's flip this over. And on the back, it's just got a generic Brain Games logo. Which is kind of nice that this is a little bit protected. You can already see that it's dinged up a bit around the edges. So, that's never a good sign. This is pretty unprotected. There's no gloss on it. That's a double-edged sword, but the image does look pretty good. Let's take a look at the other board images. I probably have that one upside down, obviously. I'm guessing this one actually goes like that. Alright. Then we've got some Brain Games tokens. There's 2 sheets of these. It's much like the scorecards, it's just a folded piece. And on the back, they have the different symbols. Okay. Then we've got our instruction sheet, which is actually pretty nice paper. And it's color, which is kind of rare for these kind of games. So nothing exceptionally interesting. The back's blank. I don't know why. They could have put a logo or something on there. And the back is different coding. But the front is nice. This is actually probably the nicest piece so far. The cardstock is pretty thick. I do like that. And the imagery is pretty good. So I'll give them a pass on the fact this isn't glossed, because it actually might work out better this way. Okay, so the die is just a 6-sided die. It's got a 1, 2, 1, 2, and then 3, and 3. So it's really just a D3. But 2 twos, 2 ones, 2 threes, pretty straightforward. It's not real heavy, but it does seem to roll pretty well. So this thing's going to bounce all over the table if you have a table like this. So you might want to put a tablecloth down if you're playing, because this thing is going to go all over the place, because people expect a heavier die to roll. All right, then our pieces here come in a little Ziploc baggie, which I do like that. And these are just standard plastic pieces. You can find these online. We've got red, blue, purple, yellow, the sort of lime green, and orange. No white or black, which kind of surprises me, but I think that's probably okay. But you can find replacements of these online. I think Amazon still has them. They're kind of a cheap plastic, but they'll work for the game. So let's take a look at our cards. Now this stack is pretty big. It's broken down by color. Let's take a look at the different colors and see what we have here. These are two-sided. Silly me. that's the last card for the red deck. So let's take a look at the blue deck, which was stacked funny, so it has a weird flex to it. That's the last of the blue cards. But let's take a look at the purples. Psst. That's the last purple card. Which just leaves us with the green deck. And lastly, okay, so the cards are actually pretty decent quality, but they are kind of thin. But the coating's good. I think if you get them wet, they're going to stain very easily because it is a light coating. Unfortunately, the size makes them kind of an odd size to try and protect, but overall, there are some good challenges. Some people may have problems with the physical challenges or the vision challenges, but that shouldn't keep them from playing. There are some in here that I think most people can do. So that is what is inside the Brain Games, the game, from 2015 from Buffalo Games and Puzzles with the National Geographic Channel, ages 14 and up, 3 to 6 players. I think it'd be a fine game. It's a good party game, and the challenges are actually pretty good. There's a lot of them that you're probably not going to know or have never encountered before. There are a few that you've probably seen before. But overall, I think it's a pretty cool looking game. The card quality is a little mixed bag. I think they're pretty good for what you're getting and for the price that this is usually going for. And there's a lot of challenge cards, so I think most people are going to be able to play this. The fact that it comes with a die is pretty nice. All the pieces are okay. So considering this usually goes for 15 to 20 bucks, I'd say that's a fair price. Not the greatest quality, but definitely not the worst. And the theme of the game is pretty cool. So if you're looking to try and do some mind-bending stuff and outdo your friends, challenge your brain a little, this is probably a good game for you. So I would say this one's worth picking up and adding to your collection if you're going to do a lot of party games with people that are willing to try some more out-of-the-box kind of stuff. A lot of people aren't going to want to play this. They're going to think it's too difficult. It's really, a lot of it's not that difficult. They're just not used to exercising their brain the way this game's going to challenge them to do. So if you have people that would be willing to do that and play a game like this, this is definitely worth picking up. So that's my opinion on it. We've seen what's in the box. You've heard my stance on it. I think it's a pretty decent game. That's going to wrap up this one. Thank you so much for watching and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like and consider subscribing so you don't miss future unboxings and reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the About page. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.